We better get into it. Prime Minister Tony Abbott has cancelled a visit to Victoria's Deakin University today as students prepare for a day of nationwide protests against planned higher education changes. Joining us now is Andy Zephyr from the University of Technology in Sydney, Student Association. Andy, good morning to you.
Hi, how are you going?
Wonderful, thank you.
How are you going?
Good, thank you. We can hear the chanting behind you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, sorry. I can barely hear you there.
Talk us through what's happening today, Andy.
Okay, so today we have the staff striking against the university management. We've been here since 7 a.m. this morning. They'll be going through till about 11:30. We'll be gathering in front of the tower. That'll be a staff-run rally. And then at 2:30, students all across Australia will be gathering together at their university or a major city. And they'll be making sure that they have their voice heard against the federal budget and against the cuts to education, the cuts to welfare, and the awful cuts to our universal healthcare system.
Andy, we've seen some visiting politicians on campus being more than jostled, in fact, physically harassed by students. Do you believe that's an appropriate way to protest?
I think that all the actions that students have taken have been non-violent direct action. If students wanted
come
to be
on,
violent,
give us a break. They've been harassing female politicians, and one was even an ex-politician.
If you'd seen Julie Bishop walking up the stairs, she was smiling there. She got through with her security, and afterwards, the video footage showed that lots of students were then pushed onto the ground, kicked, and even headlocked. So that's really unfortunate that students on campus aren't safe, and there are female students in those protests as well.
Yeah.
And they don't have as many security guards as Julie Bishop.
Yeah. Action and reaction, Andy.
But Andy, come on, don't you think? I mean, those pictures really did not look very good, and they don't do your very valid cause any sort of justice, really, because people then focus on the behaviour of students rather than what it is that you're very validly arguing and protesting against.
I think it's really similar to what was being said about the Q&A kind of protest. In fact, we've seen the biggest growth of the student movement since Howard was in. I think it's really telling that students are on campus, they're understanding the issues, and you know what? The aim is to get as many students on the streets as possible to be participating and to be speaking for themselves and be telling how awful it is for them and the struggles that they're facing, and that's working at the moment. And the Liberals are understanding that they're not welcome on campuses because students are angry at them, justifiably, as you've just said, very angry at the cuts and the increases to what their education will be.
But it's about sort of how you treat people and having good manners and respect, really.
Well, I don't know if cutting education, tertiary education, is well respected, especially when it's built off a lie of a budget deficit. Sorry, I'm struggling to hear you. Can you just repeat the question?
It was just more that surely, though, we're looking at behaviour there that is rude and disrespectful and quite intimidating, and it just doesn't do your cause any justice.
I think I'm finding that a lot of Tony Abbott, Christopher Pyne, Julie Bishop, Joe Hockey, a lot of their behaviour is intimidating as well, and it's causing violence amongst the community in regards to what it's going to cause people to do. We are going to see suicide rates go up because of this budget, and that is an unfortunate case.
That sounds extreme, Andy, but just finally, the Australian Federal Police has given direction to the Education Minister and the Prime Minister not to attend Deakin University today. Given that, will you change the way you protest?
I think that students are in their right to participate in the protest how they will. And I am one person to tell them. I'm not here to tell them what they should or shouldn't do. I'm here to protest non-violently. I'm here to protest and do non-violent direct actions, such as was seen yesterday, such as been seen at universities, and as we're seeing today directly behind me. There is no violence happening here, and I think it's a lot of spin that's being put on the media. Sorry to disagree.
All right, Andy Zephyr. I don't know if you can really spin footage that comes directly from these universities where it was very, very clear that that people got out of hand. Mm. It did overstep the mark.
And the comment about Julie Bishop smiling, I mean, what that would be just a nervous reaction to being in that situation. Mm. What are you going to do? You know, start screaming at them? Well, that's the last thing you want to do. Mm. I've actually been in a situation on campus where students were screaming abuse at me. And I did exactly the same thing. I smiled because, I mean, it's kind of a way you think you might defuse the situation. If you start to get aggressive, they're going to get worse. So to use that as an excuse to say, oh, she was really enjoying it, sorry.
Yeah, that's right. Can you imagine pushing and shoving any other woman and them saying, oh, no, that's all right, you're allowed to push and shove her, you know? She looked like
it was
she
was a Labor woman.
She looked like she was liking it, Your Honour.
I must say, Jess, you made the very, very good point that, you know, some of the things that these students are protesting are extremely valid. The fact that deregulation of uni fees is something to be really worried and really concerned about. Getting that argy-bargy, which, you know, a bit scary. Is it worth it? I don't think so.
I think
the message has been
I think there are two sort of shocking things to come out of this. One is the sort of climate. You know, student protests
suicide
have
rates.
Been around... Well, that was ridiculous. Mm. But student protests have been around since time immemorial. But
led by you, Joe.
But that's right, back in the day. That's right.
Well.
But the idea to say as though it's a good thing, we will not tolerate any divergent views on university campuses goes, of course, against the very heart of what university is all about. And the second really shocking thing is that you had a whole bunch of uni students who managed to get up at 7 o'clock in the morning. That's just against God.